Let's talk about the difference between transitivity and stimulus equivalence. When we talk about stimulus equivalence, what we're actually talking about is generalization. And the way that generalization works is a person is taught certain relations, things that are the same somehow. They go together. They're symbolically the same. Maybe they're just opposites. And in a perfect world, if the taught connections are meaningful to the learner, the new relations and connections will emerge without any additional training. Think of it like this. We didn't need to be taught that the Apple pencil is a writing device. We were able to look at its feature and its name and independently equate it to all the many types of writing devices we've experienced in the past. And that all started with probably one or two writing utensils in our childhood. Things that were labeled things to write with. And from those few initially taught relations, we can now generalize most other writing devices or utensils. So stimulus equivalence is achieved when, let's say, I hold up a specific number of related stimuli. As you can see, they're all different, but yet I'm able to equate relationships with these items, meaning I can make reflexive and symmetrical and even transitive matches with them. And for each of these groupings, when all the possible relations have been established, then we have stimulus equivalence. So for example, with this group of three, let's say I was originally taught that this pencil is equal to this pen. And I was also taught that this pen is equal to this Apple pencil. Now, if from these two relations, I derive the symmetry connection, that is, if this pencil is equal to this pen, then this pen is equal to this pencil. And if this pen is equal to this Apple pencil, well, then this Apple pencil is equal to this pen. And that's just examples of symmetry, generalization. But it is still not every possible connection when it comes to these items. So it's not complete stimulus equivalence yet. Now I need to make a transitivity relation. If this pencil is equal to this pen and this pen is equal to this Apple pencil, well then this Apple pencil is also equal to this pencil. Now I know what you're thinking, now I must be done. But no, this was just transitivity. It's still not stimulus equivalence. When it comes to these three items, there's one more needed step. So you know that transitivity connection I was just talking about? Well, for stimulus equivalence, that relation must also be symmetrically matched, meaning that if this pencil is equal to this Apple pencil, that's the transitivity, then the Apple pencil is also equal to this pencil, symmetry. And now we have every possible relationship with these three items, all the symmetry connections and the transitivity. So that means we have stimulus equivalence. Good for us.